There are many people who have influenced and inspired others by bringing us images of the underwater world. It started with underwater videographers back in the 1950s, bringing us the first underwater images in color. Jacques Cousteau's 1956 film The Silent World captivated an entire generation, and despite its questionable methods of ocean exploration and research, it spearheaded the way for underwater conservation and documentary filmmaking. Now, more than 60 years later, there's hundreds of underwater documentaries out there, from some of the biggest TV companies in the world to small budget productions. And while the storytelling and wildlife encounters vary, the images keep captivating and inspiring us in a time when the oceans are going through great difficulties. Number 10, Mission Blue. Dr. Sylvia Earle is the foremost oceanographer in the US and has been diving for over 50 years. Mission Blue details her life and the state of our oceans through the past 5 decades.
Look at this. It's an ocean full of whale sharks. I can't even count the number of fins. Are we awake or are we still dreaming?
Being one of the foremost oceanographers in the world, Mission Blue tells the story of Dr. Sylvia Earle and her work with the sea. She spent more than 50 years exploring the oceans, from deep sea submarines to logging thousands of hours scuba diving. Her life story and message of conservation rings through the entire documentary, where we see the effects of oil drilling, large-scale agriculture, global warming, overfishing, and pollution has on our oceans. I feel this is a particularly good documentary to watch for people who either don't know much about the ocean and our effects on it, or people who are skeptical to claims being made by scientists about the state of our natural world and the role our species play in it. Number 9, Shark Water.
You're underwater and you see the thing that you were taught your whole life to fear. And it doesn't want to hurt you, and it's the most beautiful thing you've ever seen. And your whole world changes.
The one animal that we fear the most is the one we can't live without.
Nature created them for a reason. Now human beings just, they don't care.
There's no campaign like a Greenpeace campaign to save the sharks.
The scourge of the ocean, and everyone should go and catch one.
Future generations are going to think of us as barbarians.
I needed to know why people were killing sharks and what I could do to stop it. So I embarked on a journey that would change my life forever.
A story nearly 15 years old was still just as important today as it was back then. Sharkwater follows Rob Stewart on his quest through Central America to help save sharks from illegal fishing. Together with Paul Watson and Sea Shepherd, they uncover corruption and greed, illegal fishing, and ecological decline.
We're not stopping.
Rob dedicated his life to the study and conservation of sharks, and was sadly not alive to see his follow-up documentary, Sharkwater Extinction, being released in 2018. Number 8, Turtle, The Incredible Journey. When most of us think of turtles, I think we have this idea of a slow, gentle animal that lives within a certain range. Restricted by its small size and its need for oxygen, they live in the same area where they're born. At least that's what I used to think, and I can recall the first time I watched this documentary in sheer disbelief. Not only do species of turtles cross vast oceans and distances, they even do it as juveniles and appear to navigate by the position of the sun, stars, and the magnetic fields of the Earth. Following a turtle through his lifespan is truly eye-opening, and with the combination of a strong story and great cinematography, this is one of my all-time favorite turtle documentaries. Number 7, The Cove. The documentary that truly broke the story of Taiji, the now infamous Japanese village, where every year in September, fishermen start a long seasonal hunt for dolphins. Through the eyes of activists and conservationists, the truth and brutality of the dolphin hunt is exposed and sparked one of the longest standing activist movements of modern times. Although the hunt had been known and documented since the early 2000s, it's still going on today, more than 10 years after the release of this documentary. That's not to say it didn't have its intended effect, as more and more people take a stand against the hunting and captivity of dolphins and whales each year. Number 6, BBC Shark. This highly informative three-part documentary series looks at shark species from all our different oceans, from the Arctics to the tropics. Not only does it contain great stories from the sharks we know and love, but very interesting pieces on lesser known shark species. Sharks camouflaged as corals, sharks that walk on land, and sharks that live for hundreds of years. This is easily my favorite shark documentary of all time, and another great addition to it is the conservation message. At the end of the episodes, you get to meet the production team that spent time in the ocean with the sharks, and their message is clear. Sharks are misunderstood and shouldn't be hunted, killed, or in most cases, feared. Number 5, Humpback Whales. When I watch underwater documentaries, there are certain things that I appreciate. A good story, interesting information, and great underwater filming. Very occasionally, you get inspirational underwater filming, and humpback whales is truly a visual treat. I remember the first time I watched the very first shot of the film, it blew me away. What a perfect way to visualize the weightlessness of whales. Narrated by Ewan McGregor, we follow the humpbacks from tropical Pacific islands like Tonga and Hawaii to the cooler waters of Alaska. This is an absolute must if you love whales. Number 4, Chasing Coral.
For me, the most interesting thing in nature is symbiosis. Two separate organisms that have adapted to each other and are now benefiting each other. They're working together, and the first thing that comes to my mind is an anemone and a clownfish. The anemone provides protection for the clownfish, and the clownfish usually provides food for the anemone. It's a mutually beneficial relationship. In the case of a coral, it goes deeper than that. The symbiont itself is incorporated in the organism. The coral doesn't exist without these little tiny plant cells. They are completely reliant on each other, and you don't have one without the other. That relationship between the two of them is the most interesting thing in the world to me.
When Chasing Coral came out in 2017, it was one of the most successful documentaries of its kind. Through great storytelling, it follows a team of passionate conservationists to shed light on one of the greatest perils of our times, the loss of our coral reefs. Using experimental equipment and time-lapse photography, we follow the team as they visit multiple places around the world, from the Caribbean to the Pacific, trying to document coral bleaching. It's an emotional ride and truly an eye-opener, even for those of us that regularly spend time in the ocean. Number 3, Jago, A Life Underwater.
Kalau kita orang tidur di laut, kita orang mimpi, usia sudah terlaut saja.
The story of Jago is one that spans generations and starts when the world looked very different. We meet him in his home of the Togian Islands in Indonesia. Jago, now in his 80s, tells the story of his childhood being taught how to freedive and hunt by his father, back when the oceans had plenty of fish. He's seen the world change, where now the reefs and fish are declining. His story is unique and one of magic and wonder. Coupled with truly inspirational cinematography and visual storytelling, this is easily one of my favorite documentaries ever. Number 2, BBC Blue Planet 2. The highly successful follow-up to BBC's Blue Planet from 2001, Blue Planet 2 is the most incredible underwater documentary series ever created. Through 7 episodes, we're taken across the planet and introduced to stories never before told in such visual glory. Although all the episodes was just incredible, the one that particularly blew me away was episode 2, The Deep. Filmed using deep sea submarines, the life at the bottom of the ocean is displayed in a way never before seen. Masterfully presented by David Attenborough and with a fantastic music score by Hans Zimmer, I truly love this documentary that in true BBC style also shows the hard work done by the production team at the end of each episode, which to me is a treat in itself. Now, if Blue Planet 2 was my second favorite choice, then what's next? There are different ways of documentary storytelling. Some detail information about the animals you're watching, other focus on the impact of human nature on our planet. And then there's emotional storytelling. And in my opinion, nobody does emotional storytelling like the French. Shot over the course of 4 years on more than 50 locations worldwide, Oceans is a true and timeless masterpiece. Director Jacques Perrin is well known for his visual storytelling and has made incredible documentaries for decades. His approach isn't necessarily to fill your head with facts or to closely follow a human character, because in Oceans, you get almost no explanation or information about what's going on. It simply just shows how amazing our underwater world is. And by making you feel how amazing it is, it then shows you what humans as a species have done to it. The music score is perfect, and to me, as an underwater filmmaker, it is easily the greatest source of inspiration I've ever come across. Sadly, the rights to the American market was purchased by Disney, and they took a masterpiece and changed it into something quite bad. So whatever you do, please don't watch the Disney version. It doesn't matter if you don't speak French, as there is very little of it being spoken in the original film regardless. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and please go check out whichever documentary you're interested in watching by finding links in the description below. I've added links to where you can buy, stream, or watch for free where possible. And let me know if I missed out on your favorite underwater documentary. You can tell me your favorite in the comments below.